for Mamoudou and Jai, everyone. Let him hear it. Yes.
What's up? What's up? Oh wow, not a lot of chocolate chips in this cookie. I appreciate him warming you up for the black comedians. That's great. Yeah, my name is Mamoudou Njai. I have a fuck ton of vowels in my name. In fact, I have all of them. A, E, I, O, U, and a bisexual one, Y. All of them are in there. Yeah, I know that having this complicated name is going to make it very difficult for me to date white women, in fact, marry them, because my name is so African that, like, the second I would marry a white woman, she'd instantly become biracial. Like, that's exactly how black my name is. Like, I feel like whenever people see my name on lists, they're like, oh, this comedian's gonna come up. They, like, check to come out here on some Circle of Life shit. Like, hello, my name is Mamoudou Njai. Let us go in there. Comedy somebody. Like, that's not what I planned on coming up here to do. I wanted to talk about white people and not Africa. Yeah, well, having this complicated name makes it difficult for me to do simple things like going to restaurants. Because when you go to restaurants, they ask you for your name. And if I explain what my name is, I have to sit through people pretending they care about my life. So I always go in and I say, my name is AJ. AJ, that sounds black. AJ, two letters, you can't fuck it up. So I went to Panera. You know where this is going. Ordered a chicken noodle soup bread bowl. It's like bread with chicken noodle soup inside of it. And this girl comes out the back like, Aj, is there an Aj here? Aj, yo, chicken noodle soup bread bowl is ready, Aj. Like, you simple bitch, you have no idea how hard it could have been for you. It could have been so much worse. But yeah, I just moved, I did Cleveland Comedy Festival. I just moved to New York recently. I mean, the ultimate come up, thank you, no, don't clap. I haven't done anything in my life yet. But yeah, I just moved here. People tell me that this is like a concrete jungle where dreams are made up, but my dreams just die slowly every single day. I see plenty of giant rats, but none of them are teaching four small turtles martial arts. Oh, I thought as a kid at heart. Keep up alive. But, like, today I saw a crime. I saw a crime today on the train, and it wasn't as cool as, like, the movies made it seem. It's raining outside, you may have noticed. This man, like, I thought he was gonna mug this woman, but he took her umbrella and just ran off the train. Like, he wants her life to stay the exact same, just a little bit more wet. Like, he has no other prerogative past that. But I did come to New York for one other reason. I heard you guys have this thing called stop and frisk. Sounds sexy. I could get into that. Turns out it's not. Why would you put two words that just sound sexy and then make them negative for just black people? Like, why would you do that? It sounds terrible. I know how cops are. You've heard all the cop jokes. I realized recently that cops are to black people what a flashlight is to Stevie Wonder. Just useless. It's not helping anything. Stop giving him flashlights. I'm sorry. Did I hurt you? Are you Stevie fan? Yeah, but I realized recently, does anyone watch the show American Horror Story? Yeah! That show does not scare me in the slightest. They need a show called African American Horror Story, where it's just like black people doing regular black people things and then the cops come up. Then I realized we already have a show like that. It was called Cops. It already existed. Yeah, but I'm not just scared of cops. I'm scared of lots of different things. Intimacy. The thought of the touch of a woman just scares the shit out of me sometimes. I'm scared of peeing in handicap stalls and a handicapped person coming in. Because they're right, this is their stall. And if they get belligerent, like, I can't fight them. Life fought them. They lost. So I can't jump onto that. But I'm really scared of middle school boys. I'm terrified of middle school boys, which is terrible because I'm a 7th grade science teacher. Thank you very much. Someone enjoys teaching. Being a 7th grade Okay, science teacher means I have to deal with these little bastards every single day. Okay, call them bastards in the most loving way possible. I love them so much. And it's crazy because, you know, when I'm dealing with seventh grade boys, it sucks because they're at the age that, like, they know all of my insecurities. Like, look at me. I look like a black cauliflower. I look like a Nigerian chia pet. Like, I understand. And these kids all know these are my insecurities, and they pick them out just slowly. And, you know, when I was in middle school, I was scrawny, I was a little bitch, like, people would beat the crap out of me, but, like, now, I feel I'm doing the exact same thing, just bigger. Because kids come up to me, like, this kid came up to me the other day and goes, like, yo, Mr. Njai, square up. What? Yo, Mr. Njai, square up. I bet I could take you. And I believed him. I believed him because I still felt like I was that little boy. And what's terrible is that I feel like I'm still going through puberty at the same time with these boys. Because I still, like, have acne and my voice cracks from time to time. And, you know, I don't have thug bass, like, I don't have that in my voice, but these kids do. So, like, I'm, like I said, I'm a bitch. Like, this kid, he was misbehaving, I'm like, come here. He's like, yeah. I'm like, you're right, sit down. Stay where you are. You want coffee? I can bring you coffee. All right, no, keep doing what you're doing. Stop doing that. Go play Xbox. Be free. Crazy. But I guess since I'm black, I have to talk about racism. I've been black for a while, in case you haven't noticed. And being black for this amount of time, I get to deal with a lot of, like, racism things. People keep telling me racism's over. It's not over. Do you guys realize that blacks still can't move first in chess? Yeah, she thought the exact same thing. Like, blacks still can't move. If progress is happening, then there should be at least be a 50-50 flip at this point. But I realized recently, black people, we like talking about being minorities. We're not that big of minorities anymore. I read about a real minority the other day. Muslim queers. Now that's a minority. You know why? Because when was the last time you saw a Muslim queer walking around? Never, because there's like 12 of them. Never will you ever see a Muslim queer walking around. I guess maybe there's more Muslim queers in here than I thought. They're like, that's not funny, we struggle. But, like, I don't understand some things about racism. Like I said, I've been black for a very long time. However, like, the N-word, like, people can just say it now. It's okay. For white people, apparently you're supposed to not say it, so I'm really addressing everyone but those three people over there. I'm not supposed to say it. But I went to a party recently, and this, like, white guy just goes, like, what are you looking at here? I'm like, oh my god. The N-word? Really? That's so 1865. You can do so much better. You can do so much better. Yes, yes, yes. No, but really, if you really want to, like, get me, you've got to, like, be creative. Like, I used to work at an Alzheimer's clinic. This is a sad joke. Just kidding. I used to work at an Alzheimer's clinic, and you forget everything, but this lady I worked with didn't forget racism. She reminded me exactly how black I was every single time I walked in. She couldn't remember my name, but every time I walked in, I was still black. She would think of things that I would have to Wikipedia because I had no idea what she was talking about. One day she goes, oh, look, it's the patio primate. For those of you still thinking about that, that's the fancy version of porch monkey. Yes, it hurts, but the effort was there. Thank you very much. My name is Mamoudou.